Hello everyone, welcome to the semicolon. This video is a part of the series Data Analytics with Python, and today we're going to learn about bias variance trade-off. For those who are wondering why we need to know about bias variance trade-off, well, it is because whenever you use a machine learning model, you would want your data to have a perfect fit. You would want it to be consistent and have less errors in prediction, and you would also want similar results when trained with similar data sets, and hence understanding of what bias and variance and their trade-off mean in a machine learning model is very important. The errors in machine learning model are mainly bias and variance errors. There is little irreducible errors, but since it cannot be reduced, we shall not talk about it. So bias is mathematically the expected error in the predictions of a model. It can be simply understood as errors which we make due to assumptions in the model. For example, when we try to solve a problem by applying linear regression to it, we are assuming that the target has linear relationships with its features, which may not be right, and the errors due to the linearity in the model in this case are bias errors. Having high bias means the model is underfitting. So bias is formally defined as the expectation of predicted value minus the actual value, which is error. So it is expectation of error. So variance is a measure of variability in the results predicted by our model. So to put this in a simple way, variance quantifies the difference in prediction when we change the data set. So when we have high variance, it means that our predictions are going to be very different when we give the same test case. So having high variance signifies our model is overfitting. So to understand bias and variance errors better, let us look at this bullseye diagram. The red circle represents the target. Having low bias and low variance results in our model predicting values very close to the target. As you can see, the values predicted are on the red circle, which is our target. Having high variance and low bias means the predictions are highly variable. Such a model is not consistent. We get high variation in the predictions. And having high bias and low variance means the model is consistent, but the predictions are far away from the target. Even this situation is not desirable. And having high bias and high variance is a total disaster. The model is not consistent and the predictions are highly variable. So let us take an example. Say we have two training data sets. Our task is to fit a curve on these data sets. Remember, a machine learning model's accuracy is a measure on how good it does on the test data set. So if we assume a linear relationship between the target and the features, so both the training data set have a very similar line. In such a case, the model is consistent because the difference in the prediction is quite low. But the line may not be a correct representation of the points, and hence it adds to an error, which is bias error. And if we assume a polynomial curve, the difference in prediction is huge. The predictions may not even be true on test set, and situations like this give rise to variance error. So bias variance trade-off is trying to get an optimal bias and variance for the model. When we try to increase bias, the variance decreases, and then when we try to increase variance, the bias decreases. So getting an optimal bias and variance is a task. So the question remains, how do we do it? And the answer is not one. It actually depends on the training algorithm. So some common ways to do it is by reducing the dimensionality of data. So reducing the dimensionality of data removes some features which add to the variance. Regularizing linear regression and artificial neural networks also help. Using mixture models and ensemblance methods are one of the most proven ways to improve the model in this aspect. In case of k-nearest neighbor algorithm, using the optimal value of k can optimize bias and variance. The bias and variance concept become very important while choosing a training algorithm for your problem. So that is it for this tutorial. Hit the like button if this tutorial helped you. Lots of new videos coming up, so you might also want to go ahead and hit the subscribe button. And if you have any questions, feel free to ask them in the comments below. Thank you.